As a mom, I can't think of anything worse than having something tragic happen to one of my children. But the tragedy experienced by a mother in Armenia goes beyond anything most of us could imagine or fear.
This is Gayan and her family. They have a nice warm apartment in Vanadzor, Armenia. Not too long ago, though, they lived in a community of shipping containers, the kind normally used on a freight train. Cold metal boxes adapted for a home.
It is already 20 years that we live in this container. It is hard to live in such harsh conditions. I show you the hole where the rats come out. This is the trap, which helps us to catch the rats.
These were meant to be temporary housing following an earthquake 20 years ago. You won't find many comforts here. Certainly no insulation against the frigid Armenian winters.
While it seemed like Gayan's living situation couldn't get worse, one cold morning she woke to the unimaginable. Her 7-month-old baby was not moving or crying, his body covered in blood. The realization slowly came to her. Her son had been attacked and killed by rats.
I saw my baby covered with blood. It was a terrible night, a horrible night.
You might wonder, why didn't the baby cry out? We were told the rats have something in their saliva which stuns their prey. When the rat attacked an older sibling, she woke up screaming. As a result of the physical and mental trauma, she suffers from epileptic seizures. As Gayan was suffering through the grief of burying her baby, she was desperate to find a better home for the rest of her children. She went to the government offices many times and pleaded for help, but she could get no assistance. In desperation, she went to a nearby church where she met Pastor Raphael.
I was shocked. I couldn't believe something like this could happen in our town. It made me cry. We sent food and clothes to her children right away. They had nothing to eat.
It's amazing to see how God heard Gayan's cries and provided an answer from halfway around the world. She didn't know, but at that time, Orphans Promise was seeking to partner with a godly ministry in Armenia, and we found Pastor Raphael's church. Because of that connection, Gayan's situation has changed dramatically. She has a safe home and enough food for her children. Orphans Promise provided her with a small business, raising and selling chickens and eggs, and she hopes to add a cow to her little farm soon.
Gayane used to ask, "Why are you helping? You are not our family." When she found out we were Christians, she said, "I want to know God who make you do these things. I want to know him personally."
Gayane is a light in her community. She wants to share her faith with others because she knows it is God and faithful believers who have made a difference in her life.
I have my comfort in the Lord. I'm very thankful to all the people who helped me out in this terrible situation.
After caring for Gayan's immediate needs, Orphans Promise went back to assess the container community. What we found was hundreds of families trapped in more than 20 years of crippling poverty, a generation of young people who had grown up without vision for a better life. It was the perfect situation to open an Orphans Promise training center.
Here, young people are being challenged to think in new ways, to dream about what they want in life, and to set goals to attain it. It's so important for each one to grasp God's love and purpose, and to understand that through the cries of one desperate mom, God came to restore the entire community.